In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, we shall pray in a very special way in this Eucharist for Brendan and Alisa Gonzalez, married today, Neville Middleton and family. We'd like to thank God, and Ms. Chantal Igami and Laura David and family, and for the special intentions of Leon and Eric.
This Mass is also offered up for the following RIP intentions: Terence, Rita and Adrian Pereira, Harry Vasu, Deborah Vasu, Anthony Gonzalez, for all the holy souls in purgatory, deceased members of the Pereira family, deceased members of the DeVaz family, deceased members of the Brass family, deceased members of the Grubert family, Mr. and Mrs. Evie Vasu, Mr. and Mrs. Leonce de Rosario, Mr. Raymond de Rosario, Mrs. Pamela Grubert and Herbert Xavier, Mrs. Faye Assey and Francois Franz, L. N. Buckland, E. H. Santinier, A. M. Reger, Joe Murray, Laurie Goodman, John Bastian, Mr. and Mrs. F. W. Thomas, Arthur Ignatius, Catherine Ferrier, I. Francis, Olive Pereira, Malcolm Pereira, Kenneth and Warren Pereira, Mr. and Mrs. K. P. Bastian, Mr. and Mrs. Philip Durant, Colin Durant, Mr. and Mrs. W. B. Pereira, Donald and Alistair Stewart, Mr. and Mrs. I. Lippert, Mr. and Mrs. P. De Cruz, Sean Rogers, Mr. and Mrs. C. P. Durand, Dr. Ruby Barnabas, Jerome Anthony, Teresa Anthony, Gerald Anthony, Moses, Doss and family, Anthony and family, Joseph and Gemma, Donald and Beryl Fonseca, Walter Bernadette D'Souza, Monica Peterson, Keith Fonseca, Tommy Edma and Dagmar Bernard, Mr. and Mrs. Rose, Peter and Sheila D'Acuna, Mr. and Mrs. John Williams, Emmanuel, Deva and John David, Susan and Annie D'Acuna, Margaret and Trevor Nigley, Hannah and Anand, Anthony Victor and Stephen Pereira, Gertrude Angie and Maudie Pereira, Harold and Trevor Julian, Mr. and Mrs. Pereira, Bernard Ross, Birdie and Jerome Ross, Bernard and Emily Pereira, and Caroline Pereira. Mrs. Blanche.
So today, once again, we are here to celebrate the Sunday Mass and to think of Abba, Father, God as our Father, especially the tenderness of God. God as a loving Father, not as a judge alone, but a Father who loves us immensely. So let's pause for a moment in silence. Let us ask God to forgive us our sins, to purify our image of God. Let us also make this Eucharist a moment of thanksgiving to God our Father for His loving care, His protection during these difficult days. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most serious fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 6, verses 12 to 16. Wisdom is found by those who seek her. Wisdom is radiant and unfading, and she is easily discerned by those who love her, and is found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known to those who desire her. He who rises early to seek her will have no difficulty, for he will find her sitting at his gates. To find one's thoughts on her is perfect understanding, and he who is vigilant on her account will soon be free from care, because she goes about seeking those worthy of her, and she graciously appears to them in their parts and meeting them in every thought. The word of the Lord.
Present God with us, Lamb of love, who died triumphant over sin. Risen Savior, brilliant bright and morning star, shining in me, light of glory lives within. You are my God.
God will bring with him, through Jesus, those who have fallen asleep. The second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. We do not want you to be uninformed, brothers, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by a word from the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the sound of the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will always be with the Lord. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah, by the blood of Christ we stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
We're reading from chapter 25 of Matthew's Gospel, verses 1 to 13. At that time, Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. And when the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, they all became drowsy and slept. But at midnight, there was a cry, "Here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all those virgins rose and trimmed their lamps, and the foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise answered, saying, "Since there will not be enough for us and for you, go rather to the dealers and buy for yourselves." And while they were going to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast, and the door was shut. Afterwards, the other virgins came also, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered, "Truly I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know not neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, my dear friends, a warm welcome to all of you. Those of you who are come here directly and those of you who are attending this service via some media. Today we are celebrating in Don Bosco Church, Ayanavaram, this beautiful memory of God the Father, with the hope that one day our Holy Mother Church will have a solemn feast dedicated to Abba Father. Every day, every time we celebrate these masses, this should be our intention, that one day the church will have a solemnity to remember the tenderness of the Father, the tenderness of God who is Father. Not that we are not praying to the Father, every day we pray, but we are looking at something more practical, like there's Christmas, there's Pentecost for the Holy Spirit, Christmas, the birthday of Jesus. There are so many feasts for Jesus and for the Holy Spirit, at least one major feast we have, but for the Father we do not have anything. So this movement is to pray for this grace. If it is the will of the Father, if it is the will of God, one day we shall celebrate, not just a few of us, but the whole universal church will celebrate the tenderness of the Father. So this is behind all these masses you are celebrating. Okay? Let me start with a small story. I'll try to connect the readings of today with the theme of Abba Father. The story is told of a king, and he was having a council meeting with the chief ministers, the army chiefs and others of the state. A very important meeting, a kingly meeting, a minister's meeting was going on, and nobody was allowed to enter. The door was not locked but closed, and the meeting was going on in full swing, and the small boy, the king's son, rushed into this big hall. He went through the corridor and he opened the door, and there was a soldier standing the other side of the door, and the soldier stopped him. Son, it's a big meeting going on, you cannot go inside, you cannot disturb the king now. The little boy looked at this man, this soldier, and said, for you he is a king, for me he is my dad, I can meet him anytime. And his father looked at him from far, arguing with the soldier, and he said, come inside. And he rushed and sat on the lap of the father. This little story teaches us that for us, God is not a powerful king. Yes, he is the king, we celebrate his kingship, but more than a king, he is a father. He is not a minister who gives us, no. He is not a taskmaster, he is not a manager. We are at his service only, no. We are children. Jesus himself says that. You are called to be children. If this goes deep into our hearts, I'm sure the whole face of our church will change. That I am a son, I am a daughter, everything will change. A lot of things will change in our church. That I am not just an ordinary human being. I am the son of the one whom I am coming to worship here. I am the daughter of the one whom I come to worship here in every church. And this is why we are celebrating this Abba Father's. And Jesus was crazy about his father. He was mad about his father. How was he crazy about his father? There's a little another nice story about a boy and a father. There was this big program, a very famous violinist was supposed to come and perform, and people had bought up tickets long time back, because very famous violinist, and the auditorium was supposed to be packed full. And suddenly the organizers got a note from the violinist saying that he was bedridden, he cannot come. They did not know how to cancel so many tickets. It would be a big loss for them. Suddenly they knew that there was another violinist, not famous, but very good at playing the violin. So they said, why not take a chance? Call this violinist instead of this famous violinist, whose they could play equally well. But the other violinist was very famous, well known. So they organized the thing, and big crowd had come, the auditorium was packed. But when they saw this new violinist and they announced that, unfortunately, our violinist who was invited is sick, all the people started booing and making a lot of noise. No, we don't want this violinist. And he began to play, and the people were chatting and talking. And he began to play so well, when there was a little silence, there was one voice And this little boy shouted out, "Dad, you're so great, you're so wonderful. You're producing such nice music today." And there was complete silence when they heard this voice of the son shouting out. When the whole crowd was against a father playing violin, the son alone shouted out, "Father, I believe in you, you're great." And then everybody clapped hands and the show went on. Jesus was something crazy like that. When that crowd which was against him, he said, "No, God is my Father. I've come only for my Father, not even to save us. That is only secondary." Why did Jesus take upon himself the huge task of being born as a human being, a child, a small baby, growing up, and then being crucified? Whenever you look at the crucifix, feel so sad. To go to the extent of being crucified naked on the cross, why did he do it? Just because the Father wanted it. Nothing else. Pure obedience to the Father. So much of blind trust in the Father. That's why when Jesus was dying on the cross, some people ask us, why was he saying, my God, why did you forsake me? No, he was not grumbling. Actually, he's saying Psalm number 22, this beautiful psalm. He says, my God, why have you forsaken me? But the psalm ends on a very positive note. So, Jesus dying on the cross, in the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus tempted and he prays, "My Father, if it is your will, let this cup pass from me." No, he carries on. That's why he is mad about his Father. He spent time with his Father. Jesus is not a human being alone. He was God. He need not have prayed. But every night he would go and pray. Why? He wanted to talk with his Father. This is the meaning of fatherhood. That Jesus was so crazy about his Father. Can we learn from Jesus to be crazy like Jesus about the Father? To be thinking about the Father all the time. In the name of Jesus, by the Holy Spirit. St. Paul would say, only through the power of the Holy Spirit you can cry out, "Abba, Father." So without the Holy Spirit, without Jesus, you cannot reach the Father. That is sure. But our minds are set on the Father and His tenderness and mercy. So Jesus, what are the things Jesus did to be crazy about the Father? He lived for the Father. He spoke about the Father. He spent time with the Father. He gave His life for the Father. And He said such beautiful stories about the Father. And one of the most beautiful stories is from chapter 15 of Luke's Gospel, the prodigal son. More than the shepherd, the prodigal son is more known in the whole world because of the love of that father who waited for the son, who was willing to go to any extent to have the son back. Though he spent all his property, he wasted his life, he abused all what he got from his father. But when he wanted to return to the father, he was waiting for him. So my dear friends, today, let us also in our own way be crazy about our Father in heaven. Sometimes we forget, we always sometimes speak about Jesus. We forget what Jesus stood for. Jesus stood for the kingdom of the Father. That's why when the apostles asked him, "Jesus, teach us to pray," they saw him talking to the Father face to face. They said, "Jesus, please teach us to pray." And he did not teach them King, Master, no. He taught them, "Our Father who art in heaven." Jesus did not say, "My Father who art in heaven." Jesus said, "Our Father who art in heaven." So today, my dear friends, today's theme of Sunday would be waiting for the day when I will see the face of the Father. There are beautiful Psalms, Psalm number 27, which says, "I wait for the day when I will behold the beauty of God, when I will behold, see the face of the Father." The Father must be so beautiful, not what we see. There used to be an image on top, I think it's still there. These are very, but the real Father's face is so beautiful. That's where the icon we have of the Father. It doesn't represent realistically, because the Father's face cannot be portrayed. It's so beautiful. So do we wait to see the Father's face one day, face to face? We should wait. All the Psalms, like the deer that yearns for running streams, my soul is yearning for you, my Father, my God, my tenderness, my love. So this dreaming about the Father, like Jesus, is something all of us have to do. For that you need God's wisdom. That's the first reading of today. You need the wisdom of God to know that God is Father, He loves you, and He cares for you. And if you love the Father, what happens? First of all, you trust Him. That's what wisdom will make you to do. You will trust Him. Second, you will live for the Father. Third, you will enjoy the freedom of the Father. A real son is not a slave, as Jesus told us. No, we are not slaves. We are children. So we are free, we trust in the Father, and we want to become like the Father. The whole theme of the prodigal son is not to be like the younger son or the eldest son. I always ask people after preaching about the prodigal son, who do you want to imitate, elder son or younger son? Most will say younger son. So no, we are called to imitate the Father. Both are not okay. Of course, the younger son converted. Elder son was always with the Father but was like a slave. He was a slave. So today God is telling us, pray for the wisdom that comes from the Holy Spirit so all of you can cry out, Abba, Father. In the deep inside, you're yearning for the Father. Always when you wake up in the morning, Father, I offer this day to you. When you go to night, Father, I offer myself to you. When you pray the Psalms, to whom do you pray? All the prayers in the masses, except few prayers, are addressed to Jesus. All are addressed to the Father. Similarly, your prayers also, when you get up in the morning, address in the name of Jesus to our Father in heaven. Connect with the Father. Live as children. Once you live as children, you're free. Even sin will slowly be removed from our life. We won't be sinners if you really trust in the Father. That's why there's a beautiful end. And all problems also, when you're troubled, worried, you will know that your Father is there for you. That's why this beautiful story of a child who was traveling by train one day. It was a very hot day and all were grumbling in the train. Second class, no AC and all that. So hot. One child alone was so joyful sitting next to, with a mother sitting next to the window. So people looking at this child so joyful and all were grumbling about the heat. They asked the mother, why is this child so joyful? And the mother said, the child knows that the Father is waiting for her in the last station. That's why she's full of joy. She can bear up any suffering to see her Father one day. So this is the meaning of the fatherhood, that we also, we may have suffering, we may have pain. This whole pandemic, this coronavirus, what is it? It's a suffering, yes. But if you look, keep looking at the Father, like the other child who was sitting in the aeroplane, suddenly there was a big lot of thunder and there was a air block and air bubble into which the flight, the aeroplane went. It was shaking and all the emergency masks had fallen for them to put on and people were screaming. Air hostess were running around telling people, don't scream, don't worry, put on your seatbelt and all this stuff. One girl was very quietly putting on the seat belt. She was putting on the oxygen mask, very nicely sitting and reading the book without any fear. The man next to her asked, you're not afraid? All of us are so afraid. So why should I be afraid? My daddy is a pilot of this plane. I know he can take us home safely. So God is our pilot. God is our Father. Let us not be afraid. That's why the gospel reading of today, second reading of today, tells us, wait for the Father, wait. And the third reading of today tells us, wait with lambs. With lambs. What does a lamb stand for? Don't be lazy children of God. You are not ordinary, you're extraordinary. And don't be lazy. Don't ask others, give me some oil now, I don't have oil. No. Be aware, be awake, be enlightened. as Christians, knowing that your children, not ordinary people, on your baptism day, the heavens open up and the Holy Spirit comes on you. Jesus holds you and the Father says, here is my beloved child. Just as he told to Jesus on the day of his baptism, God tells us, you are my beloved son, my beloved daughter. So feel that and wait for to see the face of God, like the five virgins of the gospel of today, who not only had the lamps, but they also had the oil. Oil means what? Every day's hard work, every day's generosity, every day reading the scripture, every day being ready to see the Father. Don't think suddenly God will give me long time. So many young people have died these days. God, we don't know when God will call us to see the Father's face. We must always have our lights burning. Don't wait for a long time future, for long distant future. No, be always awake with a lamp burning. That's why this beautiful song, give me oil in my lamp. Keep your lamp burning so that you burn and you also give light to others. The people of your family also can see the face of the Father. They can also see the face of the Father and they can also move towards the Father. Our life's ultimate goal is to move towards the Father. So keeping with the gospel theme of today, I wish all of you the joy of being a light, burning light, and always burning. That's why I conclude with this famous story of an architect built a very different type of very modern church, and they had very natural lighting. There was no electric lights. So some of the people said, sir, what happens when you come in the night? It will be all so dark inside. He said, no, each one of you will be given a lamp. There will be a small place for you specially. You have to come and put your lamp there. If all of you bring your lamp at night, this church will be lighted up. And then they understood, oh, this is a new concept. It's not just a concept. Each one of us, when you come to church, you come with your lamp burning. And you light up once again this light. After Mass, you go out and give the light to others. So let's be like the wise virgins who will give light and heat to this whole world. Bring this energy of God everywhere. So let's not be lazy Christians, but active, smart, good, great Christians who will bring the light of Jesus and the Father's light wherever we go. So let's close our eyes for a moment. Imagine the Father's face. How beautiful, how lovely, so much of light there will be on the Father's face. And this Father is waiting for us. The more we become children, the more we become responsible, the more we become people of peace, people of the light, not of darkness, people who are generous, anytime ready to see the face of God. So just offer yourself to the Father. Say, Father, here I come. I love you. Thank you for your tenderness, your mercy, your kindness, your compassion. Thank you for your Son Jesus, who gave his life for us so that we can see your face. The Father gave his own Son to death so that we can all behold the face of the Father, the beauty of God himself. So let's imagine being face to face with this wonderful Father, who, like the son, father in the prodigal son, will rush to embrace us, to kiss us, to give us a ring, and to put a new robe on us when we see him. And let us surrender ourselves to this Father as we continue with the Eucharist.
Please stand. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father, before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us offer our prayers and petitions to God.
Let our response be, Lord, help us to be wise.
Lord, help us to be wise.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy and the religious, that as leaders of the Church, they may be imbued with divine wisdom as to be able to guide the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be wise.
For all Christians who receive the Holy Spirit at their baptism, may continue to be assisted by the Spirit in making wise decisions at every turn of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be wise.
For the wise and the understanding, that they may use their knowledge for the benefits of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be wise.
For teachers and educators who are in the profession of imparting knowledge, so that for the selfless service they do, they may be richly blessed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be wise.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that enlightened by the word of God, we may not be casual in our approach like the foolish maidens, but may act with firmness of purpose as the wise maidens. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, help us to be wise.
God our Father, we thank you for having brought us together. We also pray for those who are not able to come to church still. We pray for all this coronavirus situation all over the world. We pray for the United States of America, for peace in that country. Pray for all the sick. And we pray that people may open their eyes to your fatherhood. People everywhere may see your tenderness and come back to you with all their hearts, with the lamps burning bright. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
By your
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and for all His holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through Him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, O Father, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Heart of the Eucharist is Jesus offering Himself to the Father. After the consecration, the priest will sing through Him, with Him, in Him, and offer the body and blood of Jesus to the Father for our sins and for all our petitions, for all our prayers, that God may listen to our prayers and offer and accept our suffering also. And the body and blood, because none of us are worthy to be here, but the body and blood of Jesus makes us worthy. So let's bring all our special intentions to this altar, all that we like to pray for. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you as worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, George, our bishop, all of the bishops, priests, religious, all those gathered here to worship you, and all those are taking part through various media. It's time we pray for our dear departed every day during Mass. Let's remember our friends, our dear ones, whom you have lost in this life, to our Father in heaven, and the forgotten souls in purgatory. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep, the hope, the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, St. John Bosco, St. Dominic Savio, St. Mary Mazzarello, St. Anthony, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, that your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her and to all of us and our nation peace, love and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Behold Jesus, the Son of the Father, the one who shows us the Father. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Sunday announcements. 8th November Sunday, the 32nd Sunday of the year. 9th November Monday, the dedication of the Lateran Basilica in Rome. 10th November Tuesday, memory of Saint Leo. 11th November Wednesday, memory of Saint Martin of Tours. At 6:30 p.m., Holy Rosary, followed by Holy Mass in English. 12th November, Thursday, memory of Saint Jehoshaphat. 14th November, Saturday, at 3 p.m., the Divine Mercy Chaplet. At 3:30 p.m., Holy Mass. From 3rd November to 30th November, Masses for the departed souls will be offered during evening Masses from Monday to Friday for ₹25 per person. You are requested to pay your subscriptions every month. Kindly do not keep it pending for long. Then it will become burdensome to pay. Hence, pay it every month. The last week Dumbox collection was ₹16,526. We would like to thank all the parishioners who contributed generously. The Don Bosco Hall has been built above the church at TV Nagar, the substation of our parish. It will be blessed and inaugurated this evening at 4 p.m. by Reverend Father K.M. Jose, the provincial. Next Sunday at 4:30 p.m., there will be a parish council meeting. All the members are invited to participate. 15th November, next Sunday, will be the 33rd Sunday of the year. On behalf of everyone present here, we would like to thank Reverend Father Joe Andrew for coming all the way to celebrate this Mass for us and a very meaningful talk on the Father. Thank you, Father, and a big God bless. To know more about the ABBA Father devotion, we request you to kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel, ABBA Father TV. All the prayers and details related to the ABBA Father devotion are available on our website, abbafathertv.com. On every first Sunday of the month, we will have the ABBA Father devotion, Rosary to the Eternal Father, followed by Holy Mass. We request you to kindly join us at Don Bosco Shrine, Ayanavaram. Thank you.
Let us pray. Nourished by the sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless and protect you, who is Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. This church, let us take the beauty, the love, the compassion, the greatness of our Father to all the people we meet. Let us go to love and serve one another.
Thanks be to God.
The fire of the heart.